What is good, y'all? It's your boy Lokey, and I'm back finally bringing you another video. And today I want to talk about this next bull run. All right, now I don't know if we're in a bull run right now or if we just had a nice parabolic rise or whatever the case is. I just want to talk to y'all about my plans in this next bull run, how I plan to make some money. Now, there's a bunch of different ways to make money in this crypto space. This is just one thing that I don't know if everybody's paying attention to. And it's not really like a way to flip or anything like that. It's just where I'm keeping my eyes on, all right? So I wanted to let y'all know. Now, of course, this is not financial advice, guys. So please do not just take that and run with it. Make sure you do your research. Make sure you make your own wise, educated decisions, all right? And also, let me know what y'all doing, man. This is a conversation. I'm nobody special, all right? I don't know technical analysis. I'm not a Bitcoin guru. Just share what y'all got. I'll share what I got. All right, guys. Two other things I want to mention. My bad for not doing videos for about 2 months. Started a new position. My hours changed, and it's just hard doing vids when you come back later. But it's not an excuse. It's just a learning curve. And then also, RIP Nipsey Hussle. I never got a chance to say that on camera yet. And I just needed to say that because he's part of the reason that I got into cryptocurrency. And also part of the reason I just felt down and haven't done videos. But I'm back. All right. So now let's get into it. In 2017, there was like this whole ICO bull run that happened because of Ethereum. Ethereum is a smart contract platform, meaning that you can build all types of decentralized applications running on the Ethereum network. And people were launching tokens through Ethereum. So if you're new to cryptocurrency, go to coinmarketcap.com and scroll up and down, you're going to see that probably majority, I don't know about now, but I think majority of those coins are built on top of Ethereum. A lot of them are. If it's not majority, it's a lot of them. And there was a certain point where it was like well over 50% of the coins were built on Ethereum. Now, some of those coins that were launched on Ethereum plan to make their own coin launching platform, their own decentralized application platform as well. And some of those coins are EOS. Yes, EOS used Ethereum before they went live. Tron used Ethereum before they went live. Cardano with their ADA token, they used Ethereum before they went live. But then you got some tokens that are not meant to go live and leave Ethereum. Some of them plan on staying with Ethereum the whole time. I don't know for sure if that's the all the way long-term vision. I can't guarantee that, but there are some coins like Omise Go. That's an Ethereum token. That's like the heart of Ethereum. You know what I'm saying? Omise Go. And then you have, or some people say Omise Go, I don't know. And then you have a basic attention token. That's Ethereum, man. Could it go somewhere else? Possibly, but it launched on Ethereum and it's probably going to stay on Ethereum. You got Engine, which was another one that I talked about before. Those are like some of the heart, you know, the hardcore Ethereum tokens. Maker is another one. Now, Ethereum has their hardcore core tokens that they have that everybody pretty much knows about. The thing that I'm keeping my eye on is which tokens are going to be like that for EOS, which tokens are going to be like that for Cardano, which tokens are going to be like that for Tron. Now, personally, I don't really mess with Tron like that. I don't dislike Tron. I've used Tron a little bit and I actually do like it. I don't use Cardano. I've never used it. I've tried to send it like once or twice and it really took way too long. So it left a bad taste in my mouth, but I see the hype around it and it does drive me to do some more research. So I don't know. But now, are there some coins within those platforms that are going to do 100x? That's what I'm looking for. I'm not gonna lie to y'all. Like, I got my main secure bags that I'm trying to hold. And then I got some, you know, I'm not going super down into the bottom altcoins. Like, I'm not going back into page 20 of CoinMarketCap, but I am trying to keep an eye on what's going on in these ecosystems. And I think if you do the same thing, you could come up pretty nicely. Now, example of that is Pios. I just did, that was my last video I did was on Pios. Pios ran up crazy. And I think it got way more room for growth. It's super early. Nobody watches my videos, you know what I mean? And nobody's really in the Telegram or anything like that. People aren't watching Pios like that. So when we finally get 5,000 people in the Telegram and everybody's using Pios and it's live, like, I really feel like it could go way further. So I'm not trying to pump that coin, but I think that that could be like one of the core tokens under EOS. Another one that could probably end up being that way is EOS Bet. The only thing is that you can't even trade EOS Bet right now. You can't even send it. So that's super annoying. And I'm not even going to get into that. But if you really keep an eye on these projects, you, or like not just those, like I mean the whole EOS ecosystem, you can find some gems. You know, maybe Pixios. I'm not trying to say it will be them or anything, but it might be one of them. So just pay attention. Now, Tron, it could be the same thing. I know they had their Tron Bet had Anti tokens. People were going crazy over Anti. It had a nice run up. I think it corrected crazy also. I think it came back down. I'm not sure. But it did have a nice run up and people were going crazy over Anti. Now, is there going to be a token that really keeps Tron as one of those leading smart contract platforms? I don't know. But if there is and you're paying attention and you catch that token, you got to understand people want their platform to be on top of ETH. On top of Ethereum. But unless people are building on there, launching tokens on there, it's not going to happen. So when people do release a token for what they consider a valuable project, oh my God, everybody that's already involved with EOS, or if it's Tron, already involved with Tron, they're going to flood that token. That's how I'm looking at it. So I mean, it might sound simple, but I really hope that y'all pay attention to that as well. That's why I was able to catch this nice Pios run up. There's some core tokens in Ethereum. I already mentioned Engine. I mentioned Engine before it ran up. But if y'all know of these coins on these other platforms, please let me know. Let me know if it's on Ontology, if it's on IOST, if it's on Cardano, if it's on Tron, if it's on Binance Chain. Yes, Binance was another Ethereum token. I'm not even sure if they're live yet as their own mainnet. Like, and they're leaving Ethereum, starting their own chain. So what's going to be the reason that Binance Chain holds value? There's got to be some project on there that becomes valuable. And if you catch that, right, or you don't catch it because it never exists, but if you catch it, you could get some nice run up, man. And that's just my plan. So I'm keeping my eye out on these ecosystems. I think that smart contracts is the way to go. And hopefully we're on a bull run, man. Let me know if you guys have seen some bread. I made some money. I hope you guys make some money too. And just make sure you guys comment below. Tell me what's going on. Hit that like button. Subscribe to the channel. Come on, let's get this thing moving, man. It's your boy, Low Key. I'll catch you on another vid. I'll start doing more vids again. I'm out of here. Peace.